Hello students, I will start second modulo, that is numerical methods. First is finite differences. Consider a function y is equal to f of x, where x values are x0, x1, x2, x3 and so on to xn, and x1 is equal to x0 plus h, x2 is equal to x1 plus h, xn and so on to xn is equal to xn minus 1 plus h be a set of points at a common interval h. Common interval h means here the value of x, value of h is fixed for all these values of x. Let the corresponding values of y is equal to f of x are y naught is equal to f of x naught, y1 is equal to f of x1, y2 is equal to f of x2 and so on to yn is equal to f of xn. Then the value of independent variable x is called argument, that is the values of this x are called argument, and the corresponding functional value, that is y is equal to f of x values, are known as entries. On this base we define forward difference and backward difference. First is forward difference definition. The first forward difference of f of x denoted by delta f of x. This notation is called delta. Delta f of x is defined as delta f of x is equal to f of x plus h minus f of x, where delta is called the forward difference operator. Here we have to construct the forward difference table like this. They given x and y values. We have to find first forward difference, second forward difference and so on to nth forward difference. To find this first forward difference, we have formulas. See here. Now we have for the values x0, x1, x2 and so on to xn, delta f of x0 is equal to f of x0 plus h minus f of x0, or delta y0 is equal to y1 minus y0. Delta f of x1 is equal to f of x1 plus h minus f of x1, or delta y1 is equal to y2 minus y1, and so on to delta f of xn minus 1 is equal to f of xn minus 1 plus h minus f of xn minus 1, or delta yn minus 1 is equal to delta yn minus yn minus 1. Similarly, to find this second forward difference, we have formulas. Delta square y naught is equal to delta y1 minus delta y naught. Delta square y1 is equal to delta y2 minus delta y1, and delta square y2 is equal to delta y3 minus delta y2, and so on to delta square yn minus 2 is equal to delta yn minus 1 minus delta yn minus 2. Similarly, the other higher order differences, namely the third, fourth and etc., are obtained and tabulated. Such a tabular arrangement is called the forward difference table. That is, this table is called the forward difference table. This is the table we have to construct using this formulas. See here. They given x and y values. We have to find this first, second, third and so on nth forward differences. Simply remember this delta y naught is equal to y1 minus y naught, and delta y1 is equal to y2 minus y1. That is succeeding number minus preceding number, same succeeding number minus preceding number. Here also delta square y naught is equal to delta y1 minus delta y naught. Like this we have to find this forward difference table. Next, the first entries in the table, namely delta y naught, delta square y naught, delta q y naught and so on to delta raised to n y naught, means these values delta y naught, delta square y naught, delta q y naught and so on to delta raised to n y naught are called leading forward differences. Leading forward differences. Next is backward differences. The first backward difference of f of x denoted by del f of x is defined as del f of x is equal to f of x minus f of x minus h, where del is called the backward difference operator. Here x values are from xn to x, means for last term to first term. If x is equal to xn, del f of xn is equal to f of xn minus f of xn minus h, or del yn is equal to yn minus 1. There, that is, xn minus h is equal to xn minus 1 and f of xn minus 1 is equal to yn minus 1. If x is equal to xn minus 1, that is, del f of xn minus 1 is equal to f of xn minus 1 minus f of xn minus 1 minus h, or del yn minus 1 is equal to yn minus 1 minus yn minus 2, and etc. The difference of the first backward difference are known as second forward difference. That means we have to difference the first forward difference, we will get second forward differences, that is, del square yn is equal to del yn minus del yn minus 1. Del square yn minus 1 is equal to del yn minus 1 minus del yn minus 2, and so on to del square y2 is equal to del y2 minus del y1. Similarly, the higher backward differences, namely the third, fourth and etc., are formed and tabulated. Such a tabular arrangement is called backward difference table. This is called backward difference table. Here also, this first forward difference delta y1 is equal to y1 minus y0, that is, succeeding number minus preceding number, and del y2 is equal to y2 minus y1, succeeding minus preceding. Why? See here, del f of x is equal to f of x minus f of x minus h. See, f of x is succeeding number, f of x minus h is preceding number. Consider if x is equal to 1, h is equal to 1, then f of x is 1, and 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. It will be f of 1 minus f of 0, succeeding number minus preceding number. Therefore, procedure is same for finding this difference table, both in forward and backward. The last entries in the table, namely del yn, del square yn, del cube yn, and so on to del raised to yn, are called the leading backward differences, means del yn, del square yn, del cube yn, and so on to del raised to n yn, are called leading backward differences. To understand this backward and forward concept clearly, let us go to the example. See here, let us construct a finite difference table for the function f of x is equal to x cube plus x plus 1, where x takes the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and identify the leading forward and backward differences. Solution: the given function is f of x is equal to x cube plus x plus 1, which is given, and also x values are given, that is 0 to 6. We have to find y values. Why? Because here we have to find first forward, second forward, third forward differences to find leading backward differences and leading forward differences. Here they are given x values. Using this function y is equal to f of x, we have to find the values of y. See, put x is equal to 0, we get f of x is equal to If x is equal to 0, 0 plus 0 plus 1, that is f of 0 is equal to 1. Next put x is equal to 1, we will get f of 1 is equal to 3. Next put x is equal to 2, we will get f of 2 is equal to 11. Next if x is equal to 3, we will get f of 3 is equal to 31. Put x is equal to 4, f of 4 is equal to 69. And put x is equal to 5, f of 5 is equal to 131. Last put x is equal to 6, f of 6 is equal to 223. Now construct the table. These are the x values 0 to 6. These are the y values which we are calculated. See, first forward difference column. Del, this is del y1, delta y1 or del y1. We know that to find this first term, we have to subtract succeeding number minus preceding number. 3 minus 1 is 2, 11 minus 3 is 8, 31 minus 11 is 20, 69 minus 31 is 38, 131 minus 69, 62, 223 minus 131 is 92. Again, succeeding number minus preceding number, 8 minus 2 is 6, 20 minus 8 is 12, 38 minus 20 is 18, 62 minus 38 is 24, 92 minus 62 is 30. Third difference is 12 minus 6 is 6, 18 minus 12 is 6, 24 minus 18 is 6, 30 minus 24 is 6. Next, when we calculate fourth difference, we will get all the values are 0. Because 6 minus 6 is 0, 6 minus 6 is 0, 6 minus 6 is 0. So, not necessary to draw the fourth column. Here, we have to write forward leading, forward differences and leading backward differences. We know that all the values in the first, which are first entries of these columns, that is 2, 6, 6, 0, are called leading forward differences, and last entries 92, 30, 6, 0 are called leading backward differences. See, taking x naught is equal to 0, y naught is equal to 1, the first value in every column are the leading forward differences. They are delta y naught is equal to 2, delta square y naught is equal to 6, delta cube y naught is equal to 6, and delta raised to 4 y naught is equal to 0. Also, by taking xn is equal to 6, yn is equal to 223, the last values in every column are called leading backward differences, and they are delta yn is del yn is equal to 92, del square yn is equal to 30, del cube yn is equal to 6, and del raised to 4 yn is equal to 0.